Hello everyone, this is Saket, Piyush and Mayank. We bring you the video lecture on sliding window protocol, which is one of the topics of the subject computer communication networks. So guys, here comes our first video lecture. So why study sliding window protocol? Sliding window protocol is studied because there is a need of reliable in-order delivery of packets such as data link layer in OSI model. The sliding window is an abstract concept that defines the range of a sequence numbers that is the concern of sender and receiver. In every sliding window, each outgoing frame consists a sequence number ranging from a some value to some maximum value, which is usually 2 to the power n minus 1. So the sequence number fits exactly in an n bit field. Now we'll see what are we going to study. So we will be studying the details of sliding window protocol, and we will also study in which layer it is used and how it is used. The stop and wait sliding window protocol uses n equals to 1, restricting the sequence numbers to 0 and 1. In other words, we can simply say that sender and receiver need to deal with only part of possible numbers that receiver and sender need to send. The range concerning the sender is called send slide window, and the range concerning the receiver is called receive sliding window. Now we will see the variables used in send sliding window. First, the window's size and location is defined by these variables. The SF window, that is the send window first outstanding frame, the second SN, that is the send window next frame to be sent, and S size, send window size. The SF gives sequence number of first outstanding frame. The SN variable holds the value that will be assigned to the next frame to be sent. And lastly, the S size defines the size of the window. Now, we will take sliding window of size 15, that is n equals to 4. The window divides possible sequence numbers in 4 regions. The far left defines the number belonging to the frames already acknowledged. The next region is of the outstanding frames. That means these are sent but have the unknown status. The third region is of the frames that can be sent further but not yet received from the network layer. And the fourth and the last region consists of frame which cannot be sent until the window slides further. This figure comprehends how a send window slides one or more slots to the right when an acknowledgement arrives from the other end. In this protocol, more than one frames can be acknowledged by the ACK frame. Here, we can see that frame number 0, 1 and 2 are already acknowledged. Hence, the window has slid to the next 3 slots. Also, the value of SF is 3 because frame number 3 is now the first outstanding window. Now we will see the variables used in receive sliding window. Unlike the send window, receive window is an abstract concept that defines an imaginary box of size 1 having one single variable, namely RN, which means receive window next frame expected. When a correct frame occurs, the window slides one slot at a time. Now we will see about the receive window. It makes sure that the correct data frame are received and that the correct acknowledgements are sent. This window is always the size of 1. The receiver always looks for the arrival of the specific frame. The frame is discarded or needs to be resent if it arrives out of order. As we can see in the figure, sequence numbers to the left of the window are of frames already received and acknowledged. And all the right of this window are the frames that cannot be received. Any frame received with the sequence number other than the R of RN, that is discarded. Now we will see about the timer used in the receive frame. Since there can be a separate timer for each frame that is sent, but in this protocol only one is used. The reason behind this is that it expires first for the first outstanding frame, and all outstanding frames are sent after the timer's expiry. Now we will summarize what we have learned. First, we learned the need of usage of the sliding window protocol, and then we saw how the sliding window protocol works with the help of diagrams and with the help of send sliding window and receive sliding window. These are the references we used to conduct this video lecture. Thank you.